Welcome back to One Startup World, our 2023 summer conference. It is the premier global startup conference dedicated to helping innovative and disruptive startups succeed. It is the perfect platform and meeting place for startup founders to pitch their ideas, gain valuable insights, connect with other like-minded entrepreneurs, some industry experts, potential investors, as well as learning from others in the business as we build this community. We're now joined for our next segment by the co-founder and CEO of Contactly. His name is Mariano Ganduxer, and he is joining us today from Barcelona, Spain. So good afternoon, or well, good evening, I guess, Mariano. Good to see you. Let me hand it off.
Thank you, Glenn, for your welcome. Okay, Contactly is a personal resources manager, app application for mobile devices, and it's all you need from your contacts in one place. All you need is regarding the digital resources. First of all, I want to explain who is the team, because I think that if you don't know who we are, you don't want to trust us and you don't going to listen us. So first of all, I'm Mariano Ganduxer. I'm from Barcelona. I'm the CEO of another startup, which is onlinechampion.com, a sports company that is offering API SaaS service. And I'm also advisor in Grupo Anova Holding, which is a real estate holding in Barcelona. As the other two key people are Angel, which is the person in work in leading the designer and UX of the application, and works for Microsoft, Xbox, Atos Media, and other very important companies. And also Jaume Diaz, which is a very good programmer that has worked for companies like AstraZeneca, Nutexpa, or Adesis. Also, we have two teams that work with us, which are Change Brains, located in the USA, and Deep, which are in Croatia, and they work with us for that project. Also in the team, we have community manager, data analysts, and some programmers that work for us also. So who else is supporting us? Grupo Anova is the family holding, which is helping us to manage the human resources and the accounting for the company. And they are also investors and advisors. Hedge Barcelona is an accelerator for startups located in Barcelona, and they are providing us guidance and connections in Spain. And also we're part of Founder Institute, an American business incubator based in Silicon Valley, which are offering us guidance and connection with investors and mentors from USA and Europe. What issue we found? The loss or disorganization of our digital resources results in losses of time, productivity, and efficiency, producing some kind of mistakes and problems to the people. Regarding to our surveys, 90% of the people think that, and the 30% consider that happened to them very, very often. So what is the solution? The solution is to unify the digital resources and provide full customization with an app. So that is create a personal resources manager application. The mainly functionalities that we are offering is to create digital identities for people and companies, to link to them files, billing entries and queries, notes, websites, links and personal info and much more, to have everything in one place, and to also create folders and subfolders to organize our identities that will produce improvements in order, improvements in control, and will make the life easier. So what is offering the market? The market is focused into complex CRMs that are set to improve the sales channels, and are also done for pro teams, big companies with a steep learning curve, user request integration with third parties, and they have a high price. What we offer, it's easier, it's for more people that wants organization and in an easier way. So what's the market size? The market size is around $35,000. In the TAM, the sum is around 10,500, and our expected sum is 105 million. It's 1% of the sum. And what is the market interest? Regarding our surveys, we have that 67% would use that solution, and 55% will pay for our service. That's from SurveyMonkey surveys that we did from USA citizens, and we get over 1,000 respondents. So what is the business model? The business model is a free version with limited features, and you can get an annual paid premium subscription, a selection, the custom functionalities that you want to get to use. And also we are going to provide a sale of lifetime licenses, always with a price over the lifetime value of the user regarding to premium services. Our timeline, we've been starting with that project in 2022. The market, we started with the market research, and then we started with a functional and content map, and then we created the company and started the MVP that I'm going to show you right now. And in the final of the March, we started with the final product. It's a much better product that you will see right now, because it's offering contact, it's offering a marketplace, it's offering B2B services for small companies too. Right now, the product that you're going to see, it's only for entrepreneurs, freelancers, or economy administration. So we are looking for $150,000, and we expect to spend that in marketing and sales in 40%, and product and staff. So we only need like $50,000, around $50,000, to finish our product, or to do it perfect as we want. Okay, this is the presentation of the deck. And right now I'm going to show you the MVP that we developed. 1 second. Okay, perfect. Please don't take much attention in the design, because this is an MVP and we have a new version with much flat design and much better usability, but you're gonna get the idea. What we are offering is a hierarchy of contents. This folder represents every user, and every user has the capability to create their own folders, subfolders, which we call decks, and files, which we call cards. Users have by default these folders, which are companies, contacts, digital resources, and physical resources, and also billing. Excuse me, because you can see here in Spanish, but we didn't translate the MVP yet. And perhaps we don't do, because we're gonna go straight to the final product. Inside every folder, you have subfolders like my own companies, competitors, collaborators of interest, public sector, etc. And also you have for the other folders like contacts. For example, this is an example of a dev company, freelancers, collaborators, friends, families. What you can do is to create identities. You can create folders, you can create decks, and you can create cards. For example, I could create a new contact, select the location, for example, a collaborator. This is a new collaborator, and select the image and create. So let's imagine that you create my own card to go straight for. As you can see, you have here all the contact information that you usually have in your mobile device, like phone, local direction, email address, WhatsApp, or the name. But what you don't have is the capability to link to this contact, website links, alarms, notes, files, voice notes, or even billing entries. So I can create new entries for every contact we have, and they can set them like only punctual or specific spendings or profits, or monthly or recurrent spendings. So what I did in that example is to create a company, to create an advisor, to create a designer, and to set the different kind of entries I have with them. This is dividends, which is a profit, this is advisory, which is an spending. You can see also that there are hierarchies. Hierarchies are cards or direct access to other cards, which allow me to navigate easier. For example, I have here my company, which is my lead. I can click and go straight to my company, my lead. Or I can go to that provider, click him and see his card and his spot. Also, we can link social media. For example, this is Alfredo's Facebook. And I insert here the link. I don't do that right now, but it's linked to the profile. Then I set it, I select Facebook, and I have it right now to go directly to his social media. So I can have here all the social media for every contact. I can have all the links, the website of Alfredo, I'm just creating it, and I can vinculate and I can see it, and I go, and I have here all the process to see all my vinculations. And to finish with that presentation, I will show you just two more functionalities or three. One of them is to import. I can import all my contacts from my mobile device, so I don't have to create every card. I will have it directly here. And also I can have favorites, like the cards I want to have in control in my favorites folder, which will be easier and faster for me to manage everything. And the last functionality is this one. This is a billing query. As you know, I created some entries in my cart, okay? But imagine I want to know what are my spendings and my profits I get from a couple of people or a group of people, no? So I don't want to go and summarize everything and go to an Excel and create it. So I just want to know that for control my family spendings or my teamwork spendings or whatever. So what I do is I create that billing query. I will show you one created here, which is this one. And then I just created entrepreneur spendings and I added the cards that I have set some kind of spending or profit. So I can see all my punctual spendings and profits with the cash flow, the balance, and the percentage of spendings and profits, and also for recurrent expenses, and then I have the results. So that application also offers a repository to control everything and to edit it or remove it or move it. For example, I can go and delete this character. I don't have more chats. So I can have everything I need of my contacts in just one place to know everything of them and to work easier and faster with my digital resources. I hope this is good enough for you to understand everything. And please feel free to do any question you have about that. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mariano. Nice job on your presentation. Very, very thorough. Personal resource manager, that's almost an understatement. there's an awful lot under the covers there as you look. I guess again, depending on making sure your phone is fully charged, right? maybe that's the one caveat. The fact that you could actually go in and let's say you're in your own consulting business, right? And you want to, you know, and you know who your customers are, and you can go in and you can access the specific contact information. The fact that you can actually go in and kind of visit like the spending or the billing side or the let's call it the financial elements of that relationship, that's pretty fascinating when you think about it. A very powerful tool, kind of in the palm of your hand there, as it goes along. And obviously, from a mobile standpoint, you know, people are on the go. Whether you're on the road, if you're in that type of position, or if you're commuting and you're doing work going back and forth to perhaps from your home to your business center. Also very, very helpful as well. How about from a competition standpoint on what kind of competition are you seeing in this space for you? And you said you only needed about 150,000. That was the ask. So you're close here on the launch.
Yeah, we're very close, and we already have the budget to develop the final product, but we need more just to marketing and to B2B business, and also probably to improve the product or the final product. But our competitors, probably the hardest one would be monday.com, because they have a lot of functionalities, very, very user friendly, very easy to use, and with a very huge marketing department. But perhaps we're a bit different because we are just focusing to mobile devices with very, very practical use for the application. And I think that we can get a gap there or fulfill the gap there for freelancers, entrepreneurs, or family administrators of the economies, because they don't have any tool for them. It's like all tools are for business, for sales, for big companies, for professional teams, but no one is taking attention to that millions of people that they need something to improve their connections and to improve their resources management.
How about any, for those of us that are perhaps a little bit more old fashioned, any print capabilities from the mobile device?
What do you mean by print capabilities?
Well, like if somebody wanted a, let's call it a paper record of perhaps some of the financial connections.
Yeah, I forgot today to say that when you're creating a business entry, you can link to them your bill, your invoice.
Okay.
So you can link each invoice to every entry you want, and also you can download the billing queries as a CCV, sorry, or as any kind of file, even as a mail. So you can have control of everything and to download that to your desire.
No, it's a pretty impressive hierarchy of documents as you worked your way down, almost as granular as you like, which is pretty fascinating. So congratulations on all your good work. You're not device dependent, right?
It's going to be for iOS and Android. The expecting launch time is for September.
Okay.
And we expect to have a software version too for PC at the final of the year, but it's not sure. It would depend on the results of the launching.
Do you ever do any outreach to potential like business associations? You think of like whether it's financial executives or the legal community or anything like the Chamber of Commerce, anything like that perhaps? I'm using perhaps US terms, but Chamber of Commerce.
We are speaking with business developers like ChatGPT or other companies for artificial intelligence, because there is a lot of functionalities that we can automatize. And also there are a lot of companies that they think that they are spending too much in high price products, that they don't need most of them functionalities. So they want to use or try our service to see if they can integrate in their business in a faster and easier way.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting when you look at the, as you were going through the tutorial there, you think about relationships and understanding people and what they're all about. The fact that you have visibility to their other platforms, whether it's Facebook or otherwise, you could really think, when you think about it, you could actually, as you're going into a meeting, you could be really well armed with information. You know, that oh, I saw you. Oh, you posted that on, and they would be like, well, how'd you know that?
Yeah, we want to aim into the waste of time when you're looking for that email or you're trying to find that product, that supplier, or you want to remember who was that person that would talk to you about, a gardener or that card service or whatever. So you have everything under control because you have everything in one place. And what we do is just link resources and just like create a bridge or like a point of meeting point for all our digital resources. And then after that, we will create a marketplace and a capability to create contacts and to create teams in and set different kind of rights of files. So you can set if you want to share a card in the marketplace, if you don't want to share your billing info, you can hide that, and you can set what kind of rights you want to show there. So it's like a marketplace for connections and for digital resources management and organization.
And people will experience the increase in productivity because they're not going to be just sitting there looking and, oh, what was that guy's name? Let me go. When did I send that email? And you start thinking about some of the stuff you traditionally do. So lots of promise for sure. Well, listen, Mariano, thank you for joining us today at One Startup Work. Great job. Wishing you and Contact Lee lots of success in the future. Please check back in with us and let us know how things are going as you move ahead. And we appreciate your participation in our One Startup World conference. Best of luck going forward. Okay.
Thank you very much.
All right. Take good care. Thank you very much.
Bye. Goodbye. Thank you.